So for the second league for tonight, we're jamming more Tron. Mana base is the same here, like I said, but it's got 18 lands instead. Cut that factory or the forest, depending on the list you're on. No relics in the main. The Stirring Sphere, Star, Scrying, and Map package is normal. Three Illstones, four Karns, two Thragtusks, three Worm Coils. Then we've got over here the Ugins and the Karns are normal, Ballista, and then they did a 1-1 split with the Ulamog and Emrakul. Over in the sideboard, we've got three Ley Lines, two Dismembers, one Nature's Flame. It's very interesting that they're not on any Veils right now, which is not unreasonable. One Cage, one Liquid Metal, Ensnaring Bridge, Ullstone, Mystic Forge, Worms, Orbs of Warning, Mycosynth Lattice, and a Worm Coil Engine. So, let's jump into a league. Nope. Guess this one's not unreasonable. We can try this one out. Didn't hit a land. We're so lucky. I can't believe we missed on a land. This is. I don't know what Tamir. Am I playing against Andrew right now? What is going on? Yeah, I think they are pulling the rug out from under me. I feel like I'm playing against Andrew. 100%. 100% right now. We're just dead. They've got 9 on board exactly. Don't really want to change anything. I think I'm good with our list. Might trim one ballista for one claim. Oh my gosh. Tragic. Well, this isn't looking great, folks. We're just gonna die to this Royal Cyan Altios. Casual triple wolt. That was good. Good wholesome fun right there. I feel like we used to be better at drawing Tron lands. Oh man. We did it. Turn four Tron. Alrighty, got an Ost on board. That should be really good for us. We'll just passing it over. We'll pop the Yellstone, and then we'll get Karn. Get one more mana, we can go for the Lattice Lock. let's bring these two dismembers. Shrimp, an Emrakul, and a card. We'll bring that as well. Scout's Warning into Flicker Wisp. What is Scout's Warning? Oh. Is that what we're on now? I'm in on that card. It's like Quicken. Why our opponent didn't add one more point of damage casting the Kite Tail first. Why didn't they attack with the Kite Sail? I'm so confused by our opponent. This is a sacrificial Karn. Sending everything at Karn. I'm so confused by our opponent. They're leaving damage on the table and they're choosing to. Oh my gosh, this is so weird. Alright, well, for now, I think I'm gonna just send out all of these spheres and stars just to reduce the amount of damage we're gonna take this next turn. Asthma image. Oh yeah, I definitely should be at 3. Naming Ugin. I think I'm gonna try to draw one card at the end step. let's cycle this mana. Yeah, like we actually should just be dead. I think we can take one hit for two, and then next turn we'll Dantic on the kite sail, take it back, go from there. Swarm coil. Look at us staying alive, because we, you know, we shouldn't be. Yeah, I'm down to get those lists, George. Probably won't be playing them tonight, but we can see for them for next week. Just can't keep a 7 today, but that's okay. If you're on MTGO, you can export it and send it to me. I don't know if you can send it directly. I'm sure you can, some kind of messenger. If you get the list, you can send it to me that way as well. Like the text file or just the text. Any of that will work. Like we've got a mirror, but they kept their 7, which means we should be dead. Yeah, if they stumble at all, we'll win, but. See what the luck of the gods have in store for us. Well, they've got Tron. Oh, this is E-Tron! Yes! Beat Eldrazi Stompy in Legacy by keeping a zero lander on the draw. You're a bold man. Luckily, we still had one forest left. Turn one experimental frenzy. You cast the turn one experimental frenzy, or did they? You're a monster. Storm count 20. I don't think this is good for us. Yeah, I think at this point they're gonna be able to blow up a land every turn. We have to rip like we have to rip the tower off the top. And it has to be like this turn. Otherwise, I think this game's over. That's it. Alrighty, I want the dismembers. I don't want the Ugins. Yeah, I'm just getting back to playing it. I've been off of it for like a couple months now while I was playing Wurza and Urza. It seems like a lot of lists are playing three to four of them right now. Yeah, I think it's because of Shadow. It's also because it's I think because Burn's still pretty popular right now. It seemed to have come back, and then it's Jund is still pretty, high in existence. In the even in the sideboard, if you really wanted to, the Wurza decks are playing multiple Thoughtseizes. I don't think I'd bring it in for that, but you could. This deck. Well, just like we drew it up, Karn off the top. No big deal. I'm telling you, the deck's reacclimating to me. It's getting familiar with me. That's good. Maybe we can get there. Hopefully they don't have a Thought Knot Seer here. A car, that's interesting. Want to make sure we make our land drops here. Do I like Boggles as a starter deck? Let me think about that. So, like, the problem I have with Boggles. I hit Thought Knot here. Hit Karn. I have to hit Karn. If I don't hit Karn, they can just Lattice Lock us. I think Boggles is a fine deck if that's, you know, if that's your jam, like if you enjoy those kinds of decks. Is that a cheap deck though? Is the only thing I would be curious about. Okay. So that's like mid 350s or so. So like I like Burn as a starter deck if you enjoy the Burn playstyle because it is a pretty cheap deck and you can do like a very budget-friendly version of it. Basically like skipping the fetches until you get your hands on them because you can go with like any fetch you really want as long as they're the red ones, right? And then later on you can upgrade those, but the core of the deck is pretty cheap. And it's a pretty solid deck right now. Beyond that, the other decks that are pretty cheap is I believe Titan Shift is a pretty cheap deck still. If you like Storm, Storm's a very cheap deck to get you into it. If you like the other mono red. Prowess is also a really cheap deck. I mean, and Boggles is not too bad of a price deck. Like, it's a solid way to go about things. But I think at the end of the day, though, it's gonna come down to what kind of deck you want to play. Because if there's a specific deck you're working towards that you want to have, it's not unreasonable to build that first. Because it also depends on what you're pursuing. If you're trying to go to tournaments, like actively pursuing like larger tournaments, then that's a different conversation than like building a budget deck that's that you can play at FNM. Do they find it annoying? I don't know. I don't think it, like right now with where Modern's at, like every deck can be annoying. Like, I play Tron on occasion, obviously, and like the amount of people that will hate you as soon as you put down a Tron land is pretty high. The amount of people that get annoyed at me if I play a Snow Island and play an Astrolabe is pretty high. So people just if like. If people hate playing the game, or hate certain decks, like this game might not be for them. Nick's absolutely right. People are very toxic when it comes to Magic. And yeah, and compared to everything else, George is absolutely right. Boggles is definitely not the biggest offender in the room. But yeah, I would say that a big part of this is going to be where you're playing Magic. If you're playing Magic with like at an FNM with a bunch of people, it doesn't really matter what you play, man. You're going to have a lot of fun. One of my pet decks is still the Vanifier Piles. That deck is not good. I love playing it. Looks like we're playing against our friend Dan here. I'm expecting him to kill us. Multiphor didn't help, but. Right, we've got like a turn five Tron, right? That's what we're looking for. It sure did. Feel like I'm just gonna do the blast zone. But yeah, if Boggles is your jam, man, I would snap it up. And you could probably go pretty budget friendly with it to start with too, if you want, so. Can we snag? Land? Nope. Might be too slow because we missed that land. Oh yeah, no problem. Yeah, I have a lot of Tron videos, but I've been off of Tron for a little bit just because I've been traveling a lot and been on Urza. If you check out my YouTube channel, there's a ton of lists out there, and we're playing some of the newer lists. Right now, we're playing the Adam list from the Invitational. Alright, so we're sideboarding right now. I'm gonna bring these two in and cut out one Karn, one Emrakul. I need to be back in just 1 second though. I gotta run to. Should we be bringing in the extra O Stone and Worm Coil and just cut all the these Karns as well? I need to let someone grab their stuff real quick. I'll be back in 2 seconds. Sorry about that. Yes, this is Fonzie's list. This is an awkward hand, but I'm gonna try it. Just told that Wurza took down the GP, beating Tron. think we're just going to ballista that. I think we're pretty much good to lock Dan out of the game. I'm gonna go fetch up a liquid metal coating. We'll stop on their draw. Oh, and thank you so much for the follow from the Crypt. Much appreciated. I do have all of my videos of all of the decks I've played on the YouTube channel and on Twitch. I usually try to stream every Sunday. It's been slow the last 2 months because I've been traveling quite a bit for Magic, but that should be slowing down here because I think next week's the last big tournament we're going to, and after that there's nothing really until next year. Yeah, I guess you can go pretty budget with boggles if you skip out on the canopies to start with, at least. Because that's like half of the deck's cost. Yeah, this is exactly what we want. Star Descrying to Ballista, Wurmcoil, and Ugin. Let's see if we're good enough. Need them. Oh, didn't even matter. So definitely needed them not to have a kite sail, but that's irrelevant because we drew the map. of mine. Okay, if we go worm coil and they have a reflector mage, we lose. And if we go ballista for three, block that, we can stabilize. We can go like shoot this champion for two and shoot this noble for one. Block here, take 5, 6, 7, 8. I think that's what we're doing. And if they have a reflective mage, we lose no matter what, so. Don't have it, Dan. No reflector mage. That's unfortunate. We got blast zone, we wouldn't live, so we've got to crack this. See what we get. Map is not good enough. Thank you. Unfortunately, I was really close. Oh, we've got natural Tron. Against red green Eldrazi. How fun. I just realized there must have been a typo on this list, because there's only 14 cards of this sideboard. The SCG Invitational Roanoke Etron Lord deck we're going to be playing next also has a pretty funny typo, because it plays Urza's Tome, and people were really trying to figure out why they were playing 4 of Urza's Tome. It's obviously supposed to be Tower, because there's no Tower in the deck, but people were like, oh my gosh, is he like next level thinking at this point? Oh. Oh, they're going for us.
Interesting.
Can have our O-stone ready. I think best aligned we're gonna go with. We'll take him off of
Eldrazi mana.
And I think we'll pass it over and then pop it on their turn. I don't want that Matter Reshaper to hit like another Reshaper or enough obligator, and then we're taking 3 damage for no reason. Curious why they didn't play their Gemstone Cavern last turn. It's not bad. I don't think that's where we want to be at, though. At least not yet. I'm gonna pass here in case they get a Smasher. Yeah, being on the Tron side of things is always great. You just like cast, you know, big dumb spells. Smasher. Sure. if this member is for sure. I think we're gonna bring in the this as well. Did we miss lethal? They were at 15, right? Weren't we 2 points shy? Didn't we dump all of our mana into Ballista and he was only a 5? Okay. What else did I spend the money and mana on them? Either way, yeah. I completely missed that. Oh, yeah. Yep. I did have a total of 7 counters. I just spent it to kill the thing. So, absolutely right. Smasher in my future. We're gonna drop this worm coil, and I really hope they don't have a obligator and kill us with it. See, we drop Worm Coil, the Obligator, we're dead for sure. If we run off Thragtusk, then we're still dead. Exactly. So we'll just play the Worm Coil and pray. There's the Obligator. I don't. Opponent is rude. Obligator is a rude card. I'm down for multiple Oath Stones. Play a turn to Lumdul's Bowl. Yeah, I mean, if I was your opponent, I'd probably just say I'm done here. Oh, opponent's so excited to blow up our map too. I still have exactly enough to do a bit of a Karn lock. Awesome. We're so good at this. Let's get rid of their only colorless source first. Oh, yeah. Alrighty, that's it for that video.